votes. Here are how things stacking up right now. The latest polls show Mitt Romney and Ron Paul in the lead, followed by Rick Santorum, Rick Perry, Newt Gingrich, and Michelle Bachmann are all trailing.
But it's not over yet. A whopping 41% of Iowans say they're still undecided heading into tonight's caucus.
Those voters only have about 2 more hours to make up their minds.
And the candidates hit the campaign trail hard today to grab all the support they can. KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney kicks off our Commitment 2012 coverage from Iowa. Michael.
Good evening from Des Moines. If actions speak louder than words, then consider this late afternoon scenario here in caucus country in Iowa. Two of the top three candidates, Rick Santorum and Ron Paul, mixed it up pretty good today. The third of the top three candidates, Mitt Romney, did not.
Thanks, you guys. Great to be with you. Thank you.
Mitt Romney, who spent almost as much time in Iowa in the last week than all of last year, wrapped up his Iowa campaign knocking President Obama, not his Republican rivals. And one of his advisors says Romney does not need an Iowa knockout. That's former Missouri Senator Jim Talent.
It's been our belief that this is going to take several months to decide. And so this is the first step on what we think is going to be a long journey.
But another Iowa leader, Rick Santorum, is keeping the gloves on. He's angry at being the target of automated phone calls questioning his conservative credentials. And he blames rival Ron Paul for those calls and supposedly called Paul disgusting. Paul wouldn't answer reporter questions about it today.
I said the calls were disgusting.
Looks like people do care.
Because they were not true.
But as they left at an event, the candidate's son, the Kentucky Senator Rand Paul, said Santorum's position on things like voting for earmarks as a senator are not those of a true conservative. Both men and several other candidates were at a Rock the Caucus rally for young, new voters at a Des Moines high school. About half of the 800 kids here said they were planning on casting their first ever votes at caucuses tonight. And many say they're also worried about things like the economy and the future.
Our Social Security is running out, and that's going to be a concern for us when we retire. So I think people are already thinking about that.
As we say, those caucuses begin at 7 o'clock tonight. Most of them will last an hour. A few of them may last a lot longer than that. And when it's all said and done here in caucus country, the race for the GOP presidential nomination will not look the same as it does now when the counting is finished. We're live in Des Moines. Back to you.